Hey, welcome back to Duolingo. I'm not going to do this because doing this is kind of pointless. What I am going to do is move on to try and get the rest of these down into gold. Now finish up people here because I already moved on to people there. And I actually need to make sure I'm getting some stuff done, even if it's on the lower end.
Bruno es de España.
Bruno es de España. De. Yeah. They don't care what order I do it in. It's always nice. It's terrible, because I don't know if I'm going to learn anything from it or not, but...
Me llamo Marco.
My name is Marco. That was weird.
Yo soy de China.
My voice went a little bit higher than it should have. I heard yo soy, and that was it. I'm sorry, lady.
Yo soy de China.
Oh, I'm from China. I'm not, but that's
Bruno
fine.
Es americano.
Whoa, okay. That was freaky. I had my mouse in just the wrong spot. Bruno is American. Which is still like a weird misnomer that happens, isn't it?
Ella es americana.
Oh, ella es americana. She is American. She is from the United States. Ella es de... Ooh, that was... Unidos? Ooh. Es... Ooh. I don't remember that one at all. Estados. Yeah. Estados Unidos. You'd think I'd remember the one that I'm from, and then the rest of them I wouldn't, but I'm not really from the United States, so it doesn't fit that way. My name is Juan. That's... Me llamo... Ooh, llamo... Juan. I don't have to say S, right? Okay. Are you from Spain? Ooh. Dude. Oh, wait. Ooh. That one's usted? No. Are you? It should be usted. De España? Is it usted? Nope. That one be... Is it... Tú eres? Tú eres de España. Yep. I'd completely forgotten that one. I was not on the right track. Ana is American. Ana es Americana. I only capitalize words sometimes. Perfect! I hadn't seen that splash screen before. I've gotten a few of these on, like, perfect with no mistakes. I hadn't seen that splash screen. Is that a recent update, or have I just never seen it, even though it's been showing up? I don't know. Crowns. I'm not going to earn another crown right now, but I need to finish up people, so I'm going to finish this one up. Mi nombre. My name? That's not a sentence. You shouldn't put a period there. That's not really a sentence.
La niña es estudiante.
The girl is a student. Right? I hope so.
Tú y yo.
What?
Tú y yo.
Did you say tú y yo? That is hard. Like, those short, barely said sentences are the ones I have a bigger problem with than anything else. Because everything else is probably something I can just hear a second time, but that one, I had to purely guess that it was like that.
De donde eres?
Where are you from, right? De donde eres? Where are you from, yeah. I live in Virginia. Yo vivo in Virginia. My name, mi nombre. Some easy ones, but they're gonna be. Because I already learned the words from this one. Once you get to, like, the higher levels, they don't teach you new words. They kind of just get you to, repeat the same stuff. Where are you from, Juan? ¿De dónde eres, Juan? Yes. Bruno es estudiante. Another perfect. Yeah, I think they added that in. Not something that I'm used to seeing, even though I've gotten perfects on these a few times.
Ella es de Cuba.
Ella es de Cuba. I did that again where I took Cuba, because they say Cuba, and I said Cuba, which ain't right.
Carmen es de Mexico.
Carmen is from Mexico. Carmen is from Mexico.
Ella es mexicana.
Ella es mexicana.
Tú eres interesante.
You are interesting. Well, thank you very much. It's nice to have some acknowledgement. You are interesting.
Yo soy cubano.
Yo soy... Oh, yeah, okay. It's just asking me to write it again. I kind of screw that up sometimes and not sure what exactly they want. The girl is Cuban. Ooh, that's... La niña es cuban... Oh, that's not the right thing. Nope. Cubana. Damn it. I'm mistyping a lot today. Though I think I'm pretty tired at the moment, so it makes a lot of sense. Vivo en Mexico. I am Cuban. I am not. Yo soy cubano. I am Mexican. I am not. Yo soy mexicano. Somebody is hosting me? Okay, that's shocking. You'd have to be crazy to think that I'm interesting enough to get people to watch. Bass guitar is something. I can't read that. Oh, got that up to level 5, so I'm done with that one. Well, thanks for hosting. I don't know exactly what that means, but I'm thinking that it means something that it probably shouldn't. Let's see. People 2 and people 3 are right next to each other. Oh, bass guitarist Joshua Wood. Oh, well. Hello, bass guitarist Joshua Wood. Because I can't read the thing above your name. I don't have that. I learned very little Mandarin. That is not Mandarin. That looks like it's Japanese. And I don't know any kanji. Well, I know kanji is a rice pudding, but that's about it. I'm going to go with people 3. I'm going to get this one up to a level 2. The teacher works in a school. Well, I would hope so. El maestro trabaja en una escuela.
José es camarero.
José is... Oh... Camarero? What the hell is that? A waiter? It's the only one that... It's the only one that fits. Is José a waiter? Because I've learned the other ones. Oh, it's just... Oh, well. Bass guitarist written in katakana. Got it. So, you gave yourself a good title there, I guess. If it fits your name, then it does make sense.
Carmen. Es.
Which one? Camarera.
Camarera.
Please? It is.
Ella es camarera.
I got that right for some damn reason. She is a waitress. I'm going to start getting that one really mixed up. Camarera is new and I don't know it and I'm going to end up with a problem for it. The teacher is not American. La maestra. Es. Wait, is it es no or no es? I think it's got to be, maybe.
No.
La maestra no es americana. I'm going to take a leap on that one. Okay, good.
¿Hablas español en la escuela?
Hablas.
Español. Shit. ¿Hablas español en la escuela?
En la escuela. Escuela. ¿Hablas español en la escuela? I barely heard what he was saying. Okay. ¿Hablas? That's a question. Do you speak Spanish in school? Yes, it was a question. I am shocked that I got that. She does not work in a restaurant. Ella. No. Trabaja.
En
un restaurante.
Restaurante. Restaurante mexicano.
Some of this is so much, is just easy enough today that I don't think it's much a problem, but I didn't hear what the fuck you just said.
Un restaurante mexicano. Un restaurante.
A Mexican restaurant? That one is easy. Some of this stuff is a little bit easier than the rest of it. Eres maestro,
José?
Yo hablo portugués y español.
Oh, I speak Portuguese and Spanish. That's just flat out a lie. When people go to the channel of the one that hosted, we'll see the hosted channel until the hosting streamer starts streaming or until the hosted streamer ends. Oh, so if someone goes to your channel, they see mine. That's really nice of you. This one is... Yo hablo portugués y español. I say that way too slow, and I'm afraid that they're going to catch up. That they're going to think that I'm going too slow for them to say it, and they're just going to fucking stop me. Because it's happened before, I speak it too slow. I speak English at school. I do speak English at school. That one's finally correct. Yo hablo inglés en escuela.
Escuela.
What? Oh, damn it. School has the in front of it, and I completely forgot that shit. She studies Portuguese.
Ella.
Estudia.
Portugués.
I spoke Spanish in school. You did. I did not. Where did you speak Spanish in school? Were you in the United States and had to learn Spanish? Or are you from a Spanish-speaking country?
Yo.
Hablo inglés. En la escuela.
Escuela.
Fucking remembered it that time, didn't I? Well, they did just ask it, so I guess it's not too surprising. And I don't get the perfect splash screen again, because I didn't get perfect. Oh, is she your friend? Ella es tu amiga.
Mi amigo Héctor es muy joven.
My friend Hector is... very young? My friend Hector is... I'm going to say young. It's the only one that makes sense to me. Young. Right? Got it. My friend Juan is from Mexico. Mi amigo?
Amigo.
Juan. Es de México.
¿Quieres mi número de teléfono?
Do you want my phone number? Do you want my phone number? That's a weird pickup line. Do you want my phone number? I mean, most people say, can I get your number? Rather than, do you want my phone number? That's some confidence right there. Sí. I want to be a French teacher. Yo quiero. I want to be a French teacher. To be. I don't think I've got that one. To be. Ser. Yo quiero ser maestro de francés.
Maestro. Francés.
Please. Got it.
¿Tienes un celular?
What?
¿Tienes un celular?
Wait.
Celular.
Do you have a cell phone? Celular. That one's a new one, though it doesn't look like they say it's a new one, so I must have learned this already. I just don't remember. That happens a lot.
Ella.
Does not.
No.
No tiene. Un celular.
Celular. Yo no tengo tu dirección.
I heard yo no tengo.
Yo no tengo tu dirección.
Dirección. I never thought of that. I've been learning Spanish for almost 12 years. I have been learning Spanish on and off my entire life because being from Texas, I'm supposed to have learned it, but I didn't have to take Spanish classes in high school. So I was learning it when I was a kid because my family spoke English but knew Spanish and tried to speak it to me and I didn't know it. From Arkansas, great. Same basic premise then probably. A family that knows some Spanish and speaks it a bit, and the school kind of tries to make you learn it, but I didn't really do that. I didn't take the classes. You're supposed to take him to graduate, but I got around that. I do not have Julia's number. Yo no tengo Julia. Número. I think that's it. That's it, right? Damn it. I don't have the number of Julia. God.
Sí, yo quiero ser maestro de francés.
Real easy. Sí, yo quiero ser maestro de francés. I took a month of Spanish in ninth grade and then a year in college. See, when I was in college, I took American Sign Language. Getting my degree, I needed to take 2 years or four semesters of a foreign language, but they counted American Sign Language. So I got sign language, but I didn't get any Spanish. And my college, they only offered Castilian Spanish. So I would not have learned, I wouldn't have learned Mexican Spanish the way that I should have anyway. ¿Quieres mi número? Oh, wait, address.
Dirección.
Who asks? That's insane. The rest of it's self-study. I should have done that too. You're probably better at it than me if you've been actually learning it for 12 years. I have been actively learning Spanish for probably somewhere on, like, 6 months. I don't know. Something like that. She is my friend.
Ella
es
mi
amiga.
Amiga.
I do not have Julia's number.
Yo.
No.
Tengo.
Número.
De.
Julia. Damn it. L. The number. Okay. That's just my fault. It's going to do it again, yeah, because it's the last one.
Yo.
No.
Tengo.
El número de Julia. So I don't have the number of Julia. God, I screwed that one up real bad. It's like three times. People three, I'm finishing this one up to the next level because that makes this a little bit easier. Do you have a dog? Tú tienes un perro, right?
Yo tengo una casa grande.
Yo tengo una casa grande. You have, no, I have a big house. I have not a tired house. That would definitely be true back in Texas anyway. He is an important doctor.
El
es. Un
doctor.
Doctor importante.
Julia,
I
gotta
remember not to
importante.
Screw those around. It's got to actually fit. Oh, that's weird. The Spanish I'm learning isn't specifically Castellan or Mexican. It's neutral Spanish. That's what this is teaching as well. Because this stuff, if you notice when you look at it on Duolingo, it's got a Spain flag. It's got the flag of Spain on it and not the flag of Mexico. But I'm learning this because, well, I live close enough to Mexico that I probably ought to have Spanish. It would be useful to have it. There is neutral Spanish, but there's also a like highfalutin kind of Spanish, and that would have been where they teach a completely different I, we, all of that stuff. Sometimes it comes up, sometimes it doesn't, but it's one of those kind of things. It's the same sort of idea, like, oh, I can't remember what it's called. In French, there is a, not in French, the language, but in France, the country, there's a place where there are people who specifically judge on what words are. It's like the Academy of French Language Study or something like that, but I can't remember what it's called exactly. They determine what words should be used, and I'm going to try to actually do something on screen while I'm talking anyway. An important doctor, right? So anyway, yeah, in French what they do is have an entire academy of people who try to determine what words they're going to use, like a USB stick. It should just be something like USB or a thumb drive or something like that. And in France, the country, most people just say USB because it's faster, but there's like they created at that academy place like a whole thing for Universal Serial Bus. So they just made a massive fucking term for it, and that's the word you're supposed to use. That's the official French word. And that's the sort of thing that would have happened for me going into Castilian Spanish. I would have been learning, like, the high Spanish.
Señora, usted es médica? Señora, es...
Oh, I swear that's what you said.
Señora, usted es médica?
Better be. Thank you. My friend Sofia is a doctor. Mi amiga...
Mi amiga.
Sofia.
Sofia.
Es médica?
Médica.
Yes.
Sí, yo tengo
Wait,
un
what's
gato.
The difference between médica and doctor? Is it gendered only? Because couldn't it be doctora? It seems like it would have been easier.
Sí, yo tengo un gato. Tengo un.
Yes, I have a cat. No, I do not have a cat. I don't have any pets. Probably ought to. Juan. Vive.
Vive.
In la ciudad.
Ciudad.
Ciudad. Yep. That one's easy.
¿Quieres vivir en la ciudad?
Oh, damn it. ¿Quieres vivir en la ciudad? Yes. My accent, trying real hard to get rid of the accent for some of these words, but it actually feels weird to do that.
Yo tengo un...
Pero grande. Pero. He's an important doctor. Ooh, you're going to make me type it this time. He is un doctor importante, right? Perfect. Got that little thing again. Almost done with this. I just got the one more lesson in this one, and then I got this whole thing leveled out. I have a sister and a brother. Nope, that sounds like some Alabama right there. Yo tengo una hermana y un hermano. I started learning Spanish in 2008. I didn't really have a way to learn, so I was using Google Translate. When I found out my parents had a set of Spanish tapes, I started using them. See, now, using tapes to learn that stuff would have been nice. I've thought about jumping off of Duolingo for a bit and doing, like, translations, trying to do something where I actually have to figure out a new word for myself. But doing something like that, I feel like I'd probably end up running into a bunch of spots where I might not get the guidance that I feel like I need. One of my issues has always been that if I don't have somebody there with me, or in this case, just a curated thing, then I don't do it well. También tengo un hermano y una hermana. Oh, yo también. Wait. See, now that one's a hard one for me. Just también. I never have learned that one, or I have and I don't remember it. I've got I something have a sister and a brother. But también I don't remember. Or I don't know it. One way or the other, but that happens to me a lot. As a big family. Two or also. Oh, I also have a brother and a sister. I do not, but this thing says I do, so I go with that sometimes. Mi novia quiere estudiar
francés.
Yes.
Sofía vive en un pueblo.
Sofía lives in a town. I forget that sometimes, because pueblo to me is like an entire culture, not a town, and that feels so weird to me to have that. Let's see. A weekend. Weekend. Damn it, I've forgotten weekend. Semana.
Fin
de semana. Con mi novia.
Mi
novia.
Novia.
Perfect.
Carmen trabaja con mi hermana.
Oh, shit.
Carmen trabaja con mi hermana.
Carmen trabaja
con mi hermana. Con
mi hermana. Carmen works with my sister. See, that one took me way too long to get. In 9 days, it will have been 12 years when I started learning Spanish, and I'm turning 23 in 4 days. Well, happy birthday, because I won't be on here to wish you a happy birthday in 4 days. And if you've been learning it for 12 years, then yeah, you probably do it a lot better than I do. And I would not doubt you can actually do a good job on something like this or on, well, in an actual conversation. I can't hold an actual conversation. There's no way. I've had multiple people throughout me doing this jump into the chat and try to say things to me, and I almost always screw up the translation. So, good job, but I'm definitely not going to be able to converse with you. Where does your sister live? Donde? Donde vive tu hermana?
Hermana.
I think that's what it's... Yeah.
Mi hermana es médica.
Mi hermana es médica.
Médica.
Is that really just the female gendered version of doctor? That seems so strange to me. It really is. Like, that feels odd that you would take that entire thing and move it aside. Still not anywhere near fluent. Yeah, it does take a lot of time actually talking to be fluent. I can hold conversations and live in a Spanish-speaking country. Same for Japanese. See, now I was born in Japan, but I have no Japanese. I have ichi, ni, and san, and that's pretty much fucking it. Doctora. So there is a similar word done for the gender. That's nice, at least. My town has a Mexican restaurant. Mi pueblo.
Tiene.
Un restaurante.
Mexicano.
Oh, hello, Merc. Is that Merc? I think that I'm reading that wrong. I've never been out of the U.S. See, I was born in Japan, and I've been to Canada, I've been to Japan, I've been to Taiwan, went in a couple of places. You need money to do it, so I had to save up for years just to get anywhere. But I was born in Japan and came to the United States, and I've lived here in the U.S. most of my life. I think that I got this wrong. Yep, I think I got that mixed up.
Restaurante.
Damn it, I had it right the first time. Yeah, I see that now. You say I got it. Well, yep, I wish.
¿Tienes novio? Carolina.
If I sound like I'm stupid, but are you actually a redneck? Redneck is one of those terms. I was raised as a redneck, but I got out of the... Oh, man, that's a hard one to explain without sounding really shitty. I don't want to sound shitty. So, this is my natural voice, but that's just because of where I'm from. I grew up with a lot of technology. I grew up doing things with my hands, just like a redneck normally would grow up doing things with my hands. I grew up in the South, though that doesn't really make any difference because everywhere has rednecks. I lived in Taiwan for a while, and there were some rednecks over there, definitely. But yeah, that's a really weird question to try and answer properly. I mean, because it makes me sound really strange to try and answer. ¿Tienes novio, Carolina? And I try to move the accent over to that. So you're just a country boy and not a redneck. Yeah, that's basically it. I grew up with broken down cars in the yard, and the grass everywhere was way too fucking high, except for the way to drive in. You got the driveway and the two working vehicles. Those flatten out everything, and the rest of the grass is too damn high. And I lived in a trailer for most of my life, but if I wasn't living in a trailer, I was living with family, so like my granny and that kind of thing. Also from the South, specifically Tennessee. I am from Japan, but I moved to Texas when I was like, oh, I want to say I was two. And when I was two, basically from when I was two to all the way through adulthood, I lived in Texas. That was pretty much it. I didn't live in any other southern states. I've been to all the states around the country because I had reason to travel around. Well, I say travel. That makes it sound nice. I got dragged around. Getting dragged around ain't exactly the same thing. Tu hermano.
Hermano.
Tu hermano es doctor?
Es.
Oh, shit. Probably. Damn it. Oh, I got it right. Good. That one. Oh, I don't know how I fried my brain on that one. That one was such an easy one, too, wasn't it? My boyfriend lives in China. That, no. Mi novio.
Novio.
Vive in China.
In China.
Got it. My town has a Mexican restaurant. This is the one I screwed up earlier. Mi pueblo.
Pueblo.
Tiene.
Tiene.
Oh. I was born in the most historical town in Tennessee, the Hermitage, home of Andrew Jackson's crop plantation. Yeah, that, to me, those, like, deep historic, I got my degree in history. Those deeply historical towns throughout the South all have, like, textbooks and textbooks worth of history behind them. But every place is supposed to. It's just that a lot of those places people, like, concentrate on. Japanese born American. No, I am not. My mom is from Texas. My dad is from Florida, but my dad was in the Navy. So, we went around way too much and didn't live in one place for way too long. And so I lived in, I did live in California for a couple of years, but that was like spotty on and off kind of thing. I don't really consider it a place that I lived. Because I more just stayed inside of a house and never went anywhere. Mi pueblo tiene un restaurante mexicano. Damn it. Damn it, I've forgotten. Is that right? Yes, it is. Thank goodness. I was about done with that one. Got done with that. And I am going to check out the Duolingo stories, because that is the next step on this one today. I'm up to set 3. And do the stranger. It's weird if I say you have a real nice voice. I keep hearing that. It doesn't make sense to me. Because to me, my voice only comes out of my nose. That's the only place it, I hear it from. But I've heard a couple people say that. So thank you very much.
La extraña.
The stranger. La extraña.
Luis está en su oficina. Luis habla por teléfono
is
con un amigo.
In the office and speaking on the phone with a friend. Japanese born means you were born in Japan, not that you're Japanese. Oh, well, you know, I've never heard it that way. That's not the way we phrased it in Texas. When we were talking about it, stuff like that, it wouldn't have sounded that way. So you are American, so that would make you Japanese born American. Yeah. And yeah, in that phrasing, then yeah. My father was also from the Navy. He'd gained blood cancer during 2011 when my younger sister was born. Thankfully, he survived it. Well, congratulations on still having a parent there. That my dad got into a lot of stuff, and it's everything on him is his fault. It didn't come from something else. And I wish that it was something external, but it was definitely his fault.
Este fin de semana?
This weekend,
unos amigos de la universidad y yo,
some friends of the university and I, some friends from university and I,
el teléfono de mi oficina no para de sonar.
The telephone. Oh, wait a minute. I already did this story. I did this story when it was back at level 1. Why'd they move it up to set 3? I've already done it. Luis is talking to his friend and his phone rings. Yeah. And it's going to be his boss calling him and freaking him out because she, maybe you should also say it in Spanish. Oh yeah, repeating the thing in Spanish. I probably should. That would actually make a lot of sense. Do the thing I'm supposed to. When you practice English, you practice English. So you're another person who doesn't speak English as their native language. So I used to teach English as a foreign language. Kind of fun to do that. follow me since, well, I only do Spanish on Saturdays, and then I play a different game on Sunday, and I only stream the 2 days a week. So if you follow me, that sounds nice, but I don't know what you'll gain out of it. You might not gain much useful. Country-raised Japanese, on the other hand, means that the person is Japanese but is raised in the southern U.S. Oh, man, there was a comedian who was from... He was from Tennessee. He's Korean. I want to say he's Korean. He's from Tennessee, but he's but his family's Korean, so he was born there and raised there. And that's... that. I can't remember his name.
Aló.
Aló.
Hola, Luis.
Hola, Luis.
¿Quién habla?
¿Quién habla? So... who am I speaking to?
Una amiga.
Una amiga. A friend. Huh?
Necesito un favor, Luis.
I need a favor, Luis.
¿Me ayudas?
Can you help
¿Qué
me?
¿Qué quieres? No te conozco.
Oh, shit. ¿Qué quieres? What do you want? Yeah. No te conozco. I don't know you. See, now that's kind of crazy. From Argentina. Argentina! Argentina, are you, you're from there. Are you still there? You're from, if you're from Argentina, that's like I'm from Japan, but are you still in Argentina? Because that might make a difference there. Conozco is, I don't know you, yeah.
Pero yo sí te conozco.
But I do know you.
Y voy a tu oficina ahora.
Yeah, you're still in Argentina. I lived here my whole life. Well, I am probably speaking way faster than I should be speaking if you're trying to learn any English. I'm probably not doing a great job of being very helpful with that, am I? I do tend to talk really fast sometimes and talk really slow other times. So I'm sure that can be very annoying. Don't worry about it. Well, I wasn't going to change the speed because I've tried and I'm bad at it. I was okay at doing it when I was teaching English as a foreign language. Merck's the same in Argentina as I am in Arkansas. Stay there, but learn something. That's about it. It's good to try and leave a place and then go back. I always taught my students that in Texas. Don't stay in the small town forever. Because if you do, the economy doesn't grow. You want to go somewhere else. That way you can bring money back in. Practice pronunciation more than anything. Good on listening. See, now that's something I was always good at in Spanish in Texas. I could listen real good, understand what people were saying, but I couldn't say it worth a shit. And that is still my problem, which is why I'm still practicing Spanish. And it's taken me years to get to the point I am right now.
No. Por favor, voy a llamar
I'm coming
a la
to the
policia.
Office. No, please, I'll call the cops. He's going to call the police.
Luis, soy tu jefa.
I'm your boss. Yep.
Tienes que trabajar en nuestro proyecto.
Okay. Tienes que trabajar en nuestro proyecto. You should be working on the new project. I have Welsh-Irish ancestry and heritage. But I've never been to any country outside of the U.S. Been to St. Louis, Missouri, Franklin, Kentucky, Bowling Green, Kentucky, and Destin, Florida. My dad, when he got leave, he dragged me, like, all over the place. So we drove from Texas, because we couldn't fly. We only drove places. We drove from Texas to Florida. We went up to South Carolina and then from South Carolina all the way over to Oregon. And then he didn't feel like driving back, so got on a plane and flew back to Texas from Northern California. That sort of like weird road trip thing. And then for a while, I didn't go on any trips with anybody, but my grandparents dragged me to a couple places like Nevada. Like they wanted to go gambling, so they would take us up there.
No hablar por teléfono con tus amigos.
Don't speak on the phone with your friends. No hablar por teléfono con tus amigos.
Toda la oficina te puede escuchar.
Toda oficina. Oh, wait a minute. Let me hear that again.
Toda la oficina te puede escuchar.
What is that? Oh, yeah, the whole office can hear you. You probably shouldn't talk on the phone with your friends when the whole office can hear you.
Ahora voy a trabajar.
Sorry, I'll get back to work. Yeah, you should be working. God dang it. He needs to work on his project instead of talking to his friends. Yeah, sounds like he's a kid getting chastised by a parent. Oh, man. From? Yep, there. Got it. That story I've done before. Kind of weird to get that. I like traveling, but I can't travel outside the U.S. yet since I'm only 14. See, now that's a good point. I traveled to Canada when I was young because my stepdad was from New York, so we drove up there, for like a week during the summer, and then we like just crossed over the border. Being born in Japan, I kind of can't help that sort of thing. But I got dragged out of the country, and I was born outside of the country. Wait a couple years when you get the ability to, and I'm not saying, like, you have to travel to like, fulfill anything, because traveling is good, but it's also super expensive. If you want to get in a car and go somewhere, that sounds great. I went, when I was in college, me and two friends of mine jumped into my minivan, because that's what I was driving at the time, and we drove to Kentucky just because I wanted to go to Kentucky from Texas. We stopped in Vicksburg. We went to the Battle of Vicksburg and looked at all the monuments and stuff there. Traveled around just going straight, but we ran out of money and had to beg people for money on for gas to get back to Texas. It was kind of difficult getting back when we're constantly asking people for money on the way back. Do you have my book? ¿Tienes mi libro?
Mi libro. Sofía tiene dos bolígrafos.
Sofía tiene dos bolígrafos. Sofía has two pens. How fascinating. Carmen wants two pens. Why does everybody want two pens?
Carmen.
Quiere.
Quiere.
Dos bolígrafos.
Dos.
El tiene, I don't tres think libros. I'm up to the set three level of Spanish. I think that there's a couple of words in there that I don't have yet, and I probably shouldn't be trying to move forward with that shit.
El tiene tres libros.
El tiene.
El tiene. El tiene tres libros.
Tres libros.
Libros.
He has three books. Fine. She has three pens. She has three pens. That's ella tiene tres bolígrafos.
Yo necesito dos libros, por favor.
Oh, you said way too many words there.
Yo necesito dos libros, por favor. Libros.
I need two books, please. I mean, I guess it makes sense if you're asking at a library, but that is definitely a strange sentence. 210, dos,
dos,
uno,
uno,
cero.
Cero. Rafael, tienes mi libro.
Ah, shit. He asked me to actually pronounce things. Rafael, tienes mi libro. Do you have my book, Rafael? I don't know anybody by that name, so if they had my book, I'd be kind of surprised. He has three books.
Él
tiene tres libros.
Libros.
¿Es un libro interesante?
Shit. Quit asking me to pronounce things. I'm not doing good at that one. Well, I'm doing it fine, but I don't trust the website to say I'm doing a good job, because it says I'm doing a good job even when I miss words sometimes. Es un libro interesante. See, I screwed up interesante, and then it still gave it to me. Rafael. Ooh. Rafael, necesito un libro. Spelled that wrong, didn't I? Necesita. What? Shit. How did I screw that one up? Ella, Rafael, I thought was a... God dang it. I was pretty damn sure that was a male name. And that, to me, I'm thinking of it as like a... I guess the French. Because in French it's a male name, but that, damn it, I was doing so well for that one. Oh, that text is longer than my text window. I was mostly born in the middle status of wealth, but over the past 3 years, my family's gotten past that status since my father's a business consultant. Awesome. I want to work with... Okay, programming is fun. Programming is just fun. I was bad at it in college, but it was really fun to do. And I want to travel with them to Mexico and other countries outside of the U.S. It's a good goal. You can use it with both. Ella necesita. So I was just wrong about the necesito. It's supposed to be necesita. Well then, I guess if I am just confused on the Spanish itself, I shouldn't be confused about gendering the names, should I? I think that I'm done for today, because I've done enough stuff that I already knew that's fine, and I've done enough stuff that I have not done well on before that I think that if I keep going with it, I'm probably going to learn something new and forget the other new stuff I already learned. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this. I'll probably do Duolingo like I have been every Saturday, but Sundays I do something different, so I kind of still got to figure out what the hell I'm playing tomorrow, but I'm going to do some game tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you come back next week. Hasta luego. Adios.